Good afternoon, everyone. We're ready to start. Mr. McCoy, would you sit down, please? He didn't even hear me. Good afternoon, everyone. My name is Jodi. I'm the probate judge here in Forsyth County. And as most of you know, we're here this afternoon to swear in first the three new members of the, well, one repeat member of the Board of Commissioners of Forsyth County. And then we'll be swearing in Sheriff Ron Freeman at 3 o'clock this afternoon. I see he's here already. I want to explain first the process that we're engaged in and how this happens. Once the election results are certified to the Secretary of State's office in Atlanta, the Secretary of State's office and the Governor's office generate some paperwork that then comes back down, to me in Forsyth County. And one of those is a direction to me to administer the oaths to these officials, and also to deliver to them a commission from the governor, which is the official certificate, which designates them to the particular office to which they've been elected. The oath process, there are two oaths, and you'll see that one deals purely with loyalty, and for that reason it's called a loyalty oath. Surprise. And there is a short oath, and then the second oath is the actual oath of office. And that's the oath where the official indicates that they will uphold the duties of the particular office to which they have been elected. So that is the process which we use to do this. And then, after all this is done, it's recorded back over in the probate court records and the official records. And then I sign some documents sending it back to the Secretary of State and to the Governor's office saying all this has been done. So that's the official process that we're engaged in today. We are going to do first We're going to do first Cindy Jones Mills for two reasons. She has some little ones here who have to leave. And also, she has done this before, so she is an expert. Now, are you going to have somebody come up here and stand with you? Why don't we go ahead and get them up here? And what Commissioner Mills has is the Bible that we've used, and she'll explain it to you, I'm sure, after we finish this quickly. But this is an old family Bible held together with duct tape. So she'll explain where that came from to you in just a moment. All right, is everybody ready? Come on up this way. Come in close. All right. And one other thing, too, is we're not going to, on these oaths, I'm not going to repeat a phrase, go back and forth. We're going to go through the whole oath, and then at the end, the commissioner will acknowledge that they're taking the oath. And then we'll sign the oaths after all this is done. All right, if you would raise your right hand, please. This is a loyalty oath. You want to raise it, too? Okay. That's your right hand. That's not your left hand. All right. I, Cindy Jones Mills, a citizen of Forsyth County and being an employee of Forsyth County and the recipient of public funds for services rendered as such employee, do hereby solemnly swear and affirm that I will support the Constitution of the United States and the Constitution of Georgia, so help me God. And your answer is, I will.
I will.
All right, that was the loyalty oath. We're going to do this one more time. Okay, you ready? All right. This is the official oath of the county commissioner. I, Cindy Jones Mills, do swear or affirm that I will well and truly discharge the duties of Commissioner for Forsyth County in all matters which require my official action to the best of my knowledge and skill, and I will so act as my judgment will be most conducive to the welfare and best interests of the entire county. I have been a resident thereof for the time required by the Constitution and laws of this state. I do further solemnly swear or affirm that I am not the holder of any unaccounted for public money due this state or any political subdivision or authority thereof, that I am not the holder of any office of trust under the government of the United States, any other state, or any foreign state, which I am prohibited from holding by the laws of the state of Georgia, and that I am otherwise qualified to hold said office according to the Constitution of the United States and laws of Georgia, and that I will support the Constitution of the United States and of this state. So help me God. And your answer is I will.
I will.
Congratulations.
Thank you.
Thank you. Before we forget, I'm going to have Judge Mills, or Commissioner Mills, Judge Mills again. We used to have Judge Frank Mills, so I'm getting confused here. If you would sign right here on these two documents, and then we'll make sure that you don't miss your signature. Now I'm going to ask Commissioner Mills to make any comments she desires to make.
I just want to thank everyone. I want to thank the people of my district for putting their faith in me again. And I want to thank my family. They have to endure a lot. And I just am so thankful for them that they're here with me and that they stand by me and put up with a lot of unfortunate sometimes things that they have to, but I'm grateful for that, and I'm grateful for my mom and aunt and everybody's here today, my sister, and I just am thankful that they're here, my brother, he's back there. But and I also I started not to bring this Bible like I did last time and bring a different one because it does look horrible with the duct tape on it. But it says so much about why I do this job. And I felt like that I needed to. I had a friend deliver her annual little poppy seed bread, Cindy Hanser, and we were looking at the Bible together while she was there. And there's letters in here from 1918, and of people going off to serve. And I thought this is really why I do this, and it's because of my deep roots that I have here, and the love and the care that even people I never had a chance to meet had. And the Bannister Road is my Bannister family. And I saw in this, and when my great-grandfather passed away, they have in the Bible a resolution of respect. And it's from being, and I know it sounds strange, but it's from being an odd fellow, which was part of the Masonry. And they gave it in memory of Eleanor Bannister, and this was in 1946. He died November the 3rd. And on the top of it, and I mean, they were talking about having respect for him. And at the top, it says, odd fellowship means working in manhood's prime and ardent youth, and that sublimest, most ennobling strife, to show for man best friendship, love, and truth. Green be his memory. In the order's heart, he loved so well through all his true lifespan. Blessed be his rest, who acted well his part, who honored God in doing good to man. And I thought, that's perfect for today, because in trying to do what's best, isn't always agreed upon, and people have different points of view. But one thing I hope that people can see in my work ethic and in the way that I try to serve is that I love this county, and I want to do what's right by it. And that's not always a popular thing or an easy thing, but it is my heart is in the right place, and I want to do what God would have me to do first. And I thank him for these past 4 years, because I don't think that all the things that could have been accomplished would have been accomplished if the Lord hadn't been in it. And so I'm grateful. I'm grateful for the faith that you have in me, and I pray that I will do what the Lord will have me do in the next 4 years. Thank you.
Thank you, Commissioner Mills. All right, the second member of the board, which we will administer the oath to this afternoon. I forgot one thing. Commissioner Mills, I need to give you the permission so that you can take that with you. Thank you. Now we're turning to our new members of the commission, and we will do Laura Semanson next. If she would come up with any members of your family going to come up with you, come stand. This reminds me of a baptism in church, trying to get everybody to come up. Everybody come on and get in close here. All right, we will be doing the same here, and that is administering two oaths. And we'll do it the same way we did before. If you'd raise your right hand, please. I, Laura O. Semanson, a citizen of Forsyth County and being an employee of Forsyth County and the recipient of public funds for services rendered as such employee, do hereby solemnly swear and affirm that I will support the Constitution of the United States and the Constitution of Georgia, so help me God. And your answer is, I will.
I will.
All right, now the official oath of County Commissioner. I, Laura O. Semanson, do swear or affirm that I will well and truly discharge the duties of Commissioner for Forsyth County in all matters which require my official action, to the best of my knowledge and skill, and I will so act as my judgment will be the most conducive to the welfare and best interests of the entire county. I have been a resident thereof for the time required by the Constitution and laws of this state. I do further solemnly swear or affirm that I am not the holder of any unaccounted for public money due this state or any political subdivision or authority thereof, that I am not the holder of any office of trust under the government of the United States, any other state, or any foreign state, which I am prohibited from holding by the laws of the state of Georgia, and that I am otherwise qualified to hold said office according to the Constitution of the United States and laws of Georgia, and that I will support the constitutions of the United States and of this state. So help me God. And your answer is, I will.
I will.
Congratulations. I'm going to have Ms. Semanson sign the two oaths now that she just took. If you would sign right under your name there. And here. And now, do you wish to make some comments?
I'll be brief because I didn't prepare anything. Just want to thank, first of all, my family who went through a very long campaign season, only to be followed up by a lot of long nights of me trying to get ahead on this new job of mine. I also want to thank all of my supporters, all of the residents of Forsyth County, who I am honored and humbled to be in your service. I just am looking forward to the challenges ahead, and I hope to serve you with honor and integrity. Thank you.
I didn't know if I should answer that phone over there or not. It wasn't my cell phone. All right. Commissioner Richard Swope, if you would come up, please. And the family is going to stand with you. You're being summoned.
That was a summons.
Yes. Bonnie, get close to us. Everybody here?
Parents are getting
it. All right. First of all, we'll do as we did with the other two commissioners, the loyalty oath. If you'd raise your right hand, please. I, Richard Swope, a citizen of Forsyth County and being an employee of Forsyth County, and the recipient of public funds for services rendered as such employee, do hereby solemnly swear and affirm that I will support the Constitution of the United States and the Constitution of Georgia, so help me God. And your answer is I will.
I will.
Okay. Now the official oath of the county commissioner. I, Richard Swope, do swear or affirm that I will well and truly discharge the duties of commissioner for Forsyth County in all matters which require my official action to the best of my knowledge and skill, and that I will so act as my judgment will be most conducive to the welfare and best interests of the entire county. I have been a resident thereof for the time required by the Constitution and the laws of this state. I do further solemnly swear or affirm that I am not the holder of any unaccounted for public money due this state or any political subdivision or authority thereof, that I am not the holder of any office of trust under the government of the United States, any other state, or any foreign state, which I am prohibited from holding by the laws of the state of Georgia, and that I am otherwise qualified to hold said office according to the Constitution of the United States and laws of Georgia, and that I will support the Constitution of the United States and of this state, so help me God. The answer is I will.
I will.
Congratulations.
Sign first.
Right there.
I'll follow your finger since my glasses aren't on.
And right there. Terrific.
Thank you, sir. Well, like Laura, I did not have prepared remarks, but that's not stopped me before, but I will keep it brief as well. I do want to thank everyone for the support, for the opportunity. A little more than a year ago, we embarked on this adventure without really quite knowing where it would take us. But I will say that each day I gain a keener appreciation for what a great county we have, but more importantly for what great people are here. I can say unequivocally that the thing that I have appreciated the most are the various coffee meetings, and it's not for the coffee, it's for the meetings. But the opportunity to see just the talent, the support, the friendship, everything that makes this area the community that it is. So I'm looking forward to serving. I'm looking forward to serving with the other commissioners, the other elected officials, working with the people in the community, and just very optimistic for next year. Thank you.
All right, that concludes this part of our swearing-in this afternoon. I do believe that you want to take some pictures, is that correct? So if you could just wait for a minute, the public affairs office of the county wants to have some pictures taken up here, and then you can grab the new commissioners. And then don't forget, at 3:00, we will be doing the ceremony for our new sheriff, Ron Freeman. Thank you very much.
Thank you.
We've been delayed slightly, most by some technical difficulties, but we have this fixed. Did everybody get in back there? All right, this is the, some of you were here for the 2 o'clock ceremonies where we swore in the three commissioners, members of the Board of Commissioners, the two new ones and Cindy Mills, who were successful in the last election. And you heard me explain the procedures that we're following here today, but there are a lot of you who weren't here then, so I will go through it again so you will know what we are doing here in the ceremony for newly elected Sheriff Ron Freeman. What occurs in these procedure is after a public official is elected by the citizens of the county, that is certified to the Secretary of State's office down in Atlanta. And that causes a procedure to begin where the governor and the Secretary of State generate certain documents that are then sent down to the probate judge, myself here, Woody Jordan, forgot to introduce myself, where I am instructed to administer the oath, deliver the commission, and do several other things. The documents that come down are signed here today as we go through this ceremony, and then after being recorded back at my office, they're sent back down to the state capitol for recording down there. So the procedure is followed, and there's a record of what we do here today all the way down. Another thing that I need to do today is deliver the commission to soon to be Sheriff Freeman. So we will do that also. The commission is the direction from the governor saying that you've been elected and you're to perform the duties of the sheriff of Forsyth County. I'll be administering two oaths today. The first oath will be a shorter oath, and that is the loyalty oath. Then the second oath will be the actual oath of office for Sheriff of Forsyth County. So, Sheriff-elect Freeman, if you would come up, please, with your family members. Administering two oaths, and the first oath is the loyalty oath. So, Sheriff-elect Freeman, if you would raise your right hand. I, Ronnie H. Freeman, a citizen of Forsyth County, and being an employee of Forsyth County, and the recipient of public funds for services rendered as such employee, do hereby solemnly swear and affirm that I will support the Constitution of the United States and the Constitution of Georgia. So help me God, and you answer, I will.
I will.
All right, now we'll do the official oath of sheriff. I, Ronnie H. Freeman, do solemnly swear or affirm that I will faithfully execute all writs, warrants, precepts, and processes directed to me as sheriff of this county, or which are directed to all sheriffs of this state, or to any other sheriff specially, which I can lawfully execute, and true returns make in all things well and truly, without malice or partiality, perform the duties of the office of sheriff of Forsyth County during my continuance therein, and take only my lawful fees. I do further solemnly swear or affirm that I am not the holder of any unaccounted for public money due this state, or any political subdivision or authority thereof, that I am not the holder of any office of trust under the government of the United States, any other state, or any foreign state, which I am prohibited from holding by the laws of the state of Georgia, And that I am otherwise qualified to hold said office according to the Constitution of the United States and laws of Georgia. And that I will support the Constitution of the United States and of this state, so help me God. And you answer, I will.
I will.
Congratulations. Media here turned around and took a picture of the crowd. We have a couple more things to do here. I'm going to ask Sheriff-elect Freeman to sign the oath that he just took. And I'm going to ask Sheriff-elect Freeman to make some comments in just a second. I want to, before he does that, though, I want to mention to you, and I'll probably mention it again after his comments. I believe that they'll want to take a couple pictures up here, so don't rush to the front after we finish. So we'll give him a chance to do that. So, Sheriff Freeman.
Thank you, Your Honor. Wow. Culmination of a lifelong dream. First of all, I'd like to say thank you to my family for being here. I'd like to thank every citizen in this county who gave me their support. Whether you were in support of me in an election or not, I am happy to serve as your sheriff. It is an honor. It is a humbling honor to serve as your sheriff. I'd like to recognize that there's so many elected officials here. I would like to recognize the two sheriffs in the room. Sheriff John Wilcher from Chatham County. Sheriff Frank Reynolds, new sheriff in Cherokee. So I truly appreciate the members of our judiciary, our other elected officials, our other constitutional officers for being here, and most importantly, thank you for being here. I know I didn't send out but a few invitations, so I am a little overwhelmed and underprepared in that. We've got a big road ahead of us. We have a great opportunity. I look at the men and women in those uniforms standing in the back of the room. Folks, they're impeccable. They're outstanding. And I am honored to have the opportunity to lead those men and women to protect you, to do the things that we need to do in this county for the right reasons. Again, I can't thank you enough. Thank you for your trust. Thank you for being here. And please, please support those men and women in that brown and green in the back. Thank you very much.
Conclude our ceremony for today, except for the pictures I mentioned. So wait just a minute so that we can get some pictures of Sheriff Freeman and his family, and then feel free to mob the front. Thank you.
You can do it for me. Do it for me.
intermission. There we go.
Right here on me. Good.
If y'all too will send me those photos.
Yeah, absolutely.
We'll put those in an FBI National Academy magazine.
Whatever you need to do, buddy.
Right. You know how to get hold of it. Thank you.
Yeah, I'll send it.
Thanks, Jim. So.
You actually know him from all the way from
Brooklyn?
Yeah.
He's holding my arms, so I can't do that.